السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. إن شاء الله تعالى وستارت سورة غافر، سورة غافر، سورة نمبر 40. And we'll try to take the first three verses briefly إن شاء الله تعالى. And سورة غافر is a مكي سورة. And it's also called Surah Al-Mu'min, Surah Al-Mu'min. And it's mentioned in the hadith of the Prophet والسلام, that the Prophet recited Hamim Al-Mu'min because of the Mu'min of Adi Fir'aun is mentioned in the Surah. Also, some called it Surah Al-Tawl because it's mentioned in the third verse. But this is a very rare name to the Surah. And it was said, even though, as we said, there's no authenticity to the order of revelation to the surahs, but it was said, it's mentioned in the books of the tafsir, that it was revealed after Surah Az-Zumar and before Surah Fussilat, the way it is in the Mus'haf, as the Hawamim, the Hamims, they have been revealed in that particular order. So we'll start, inshallah ta'ala, and of course the surah is like the Makki surahs, establishes matters of belief and the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in the surah, of course, to establish this with some of the stories of the past, and one of which is the mu'min of Ali Fir'aun. So we'll start, inshallah ta'ala, with the surah, with the first three verses. So recite after me, inshallah. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajeem. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم حاميم تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز العليم غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير So Hamim, then you have here the Mad, six counts. The Ha is just two counts, and then the Mim, six counts. Tanzilu, this is Ikhfa, Tanzilu al-Kitabi, Minallahi al-Azizi al-Alim, Ghafiri al-Dhanbi. The rain is heavy, and al-Dhanbi. The noon with sukun after the ba'. وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول. ذي الطول. لا, four or five counts. لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير. And the ra is light. The translation of the verses after Hamim. The revelation of the book is from Allah, the Almighty, the Unknower, the forgiver of sin. The acceptor of repentance, the severe in punishment, the bestower of favors, la ilaha illa hu, none has the right to be worshipped but he, to him is the final return. The surah is from the Hawamim, they call it, the ones that starts with Hamim. And as mentioned in the previous surahs, of how some of the surahs of the Quran, they start with letters, that the correct opinion in it, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best what does it mean. If when it comes to the meaning, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best what it means. But it's very clear that these are letters from the same language that the people speak. And usually, once these letters, the surah starts with, you would find right after that, the Quran is mentioned. So this is the challenge to the people, that this Quran, the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the miraculous speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is made from the same letters that they speak. and no one can bring the like of it. So the surah starts with Hamim, تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز العليم. تنزيل الكتاب, the book is the Quran. تنزيل comes from نزل, comes down. That means this Quran is brought down. And it's mentioned as a noun to show that the fact that this is not just an act and it's just a simple matter, but to show the importance of it, that this comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. تنزيل الكتاب من الله, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, العزيز, the Almighty, the one no one can defeat, العليم, the knower of all things. As they say, even in the Arab of the verse, تنزيل can be like a khabar to a mubtada, and the mubtada is هذا تنزيل, this is تنزيل. The mubtada is not there, which to show again the importance that this Quran has, to stress the meaning that it's been brought down from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-aziz al-alim, the almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one that is able to do all things. Nobody can defeat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this has by itself warning to the disbelievers, those who disbelieve in the Quran, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to remind them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-aziz, the almighty, and al-alim, the knower, the one that knows all things, that the ilm of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompasses everything. And of course the surah, since it was revealed in Mecca, so the disbelievers are addressed by this. So to make it very clear from the very beginning, and the challenge that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala challenged humanity and the disbelievers when it comes to the book of Allah. تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز العليم غافر الذنب. Then the verse talks about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he is غافر الذنب, he is the one that forgives the sin, وقابل التوب, and he's the one that accepts the tawbah, the repentance. And this is at all times, and it's also mentioned as غافر and قابل. That means that something that belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, none but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he subhanahu wa ta'ala is شديد العقاب, the severe in punishment. So he subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives the sins and he accepts the repentance, and he is shadid and severe in his punishment. And the forgiveness and the punishment are both from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, based on the might and power of Allah, based on the knowledge of Allah, who deserves to be forgiven and who deserves to be punished, and by the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So no one will be treated with any injustice. And this is like the ayah, نبئ عبادي أني أنا الغفور الرحيم وأن عذابي هو العذاب الأليم. Inform my slaves that indeed I am the most forgiver, the most merciful, and that my punishment is the painful one. And this is, as Ibn Kathir رحمه الله, he said, this is so many in the Quran you would find this, so that the reciter of the Quran, so that the slave of Allah, the believer, and whoever recites the Quran is always between الرجاء والخوف, between the hope for the rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So going back and forth in this, and this, these are two separate acts of ubudiyya, of worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that a person should observe. Like when we stand in salah, there is standing, there is ruku', there is sujood. The same thing when we're reciting the Quran, we're supposed to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with these different acts of worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So غافر الذنب وقابل التوب. And as you see here again, the words that are used is very precise, of course, because this is the speech of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is like explaining what's mentioned before. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is as if you know, the He forgives the sins to those who say La ilaha illallah, for those who repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from disbelief. But if they continue to be in the state of disbelief, there's no repentance for them till they repent from that sin, that no other sin is the like of it, meaning every sin can be forgiven except the shirk, if a person dies in the state of shirk. And that's why Imam Sa'di rahimahullah, he said that غافر الذنب للمذنبين, he forgives the sins to the sinners, وقابل التوبة. He is the one that accepts the tawbah from the تائبين, from those who repent. شديد العقاب, severe in punishment, for those who transgress the limits and disobey him and they did not repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ذي الطول, ذي الطول, that means the one that has the favor and the favors and the bounties upon the people. So so this is some of the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as you know, the at-tawl, as it will be mentioned inshallah ta'ala, comes into the meaning of al-fadl or the bounty from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he said, the at-tawl, the ni'am, the owner of the favors, the al-ghina was-sa'a, the one that is the most rich, the one that is spacious in all things. So this is all from the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as Imam Sa'di rahimahullah, he said that with these attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that are mentioned, which is basically perfect attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that means therefore he's the only one worthy of worship. That's why it says La ilaha illahu ilayhi al-masir. So the what's mentioned about the Quran, that it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then it talks about these attributes and names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, leaves the reciter of the Quran from the very beginning that there's no other rational choice except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship. Because the Quran, it either informs the people of the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his actions, and these are here in these, you know, couple of verses, talks about the names of Allah, the attributes of Allah, the actions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or it talks about matters of unseen, or whether it's in the past or in the future, or the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that are mentioned. And that's why the tawl. And it talks also, the Quran talks about the punishment of Allah for those who disobey Allah and disbelief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also the Quran always calls the people to repent and to seek forgiveness from Allah. So basically you see in these three verses, or these two verses after Hamim, that it gives you the message of the Quran, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship. And the reason for that is as mentioned, with the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what's mentioned in these verses, which is basically repeated throughout the Quran, throughout the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when it comes to every subject of it, it's a detailed subject in the Quran, as we heard. But when we look at the verses, again, Hamim, and then you see Tanzil from Nazala, Al-Kitab, Min Allah Al-Aziz Al-Alim, from Ain, Zay, Zay, and then Alim from Al-Ilm, Ghafir Al-Dhambi, Wa Qabil Al-Tawbi, from Qaf Ba'lam, Al-Tawb, which is Tawbah, the repentance. And this is, you know, the at-tawb as ghafir, as tanzil. So it's the any return. Whenever a person returns to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts their return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Shadid from Shin Dal Dal, al-iqab is the punishment from Ain Qaf Ba. The tawl, the owner of at-tawl, which is the abundance or bounties. And this is even the word al-tul, or something is tall, is the same three letters, and it has some resemblance because it comes from the extension of things. You know, so it's the tawl, the one that is the owner of. So the owner of all bounties is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La ilaha illahu, there is no one worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ilayhi, to him is al-masir, or the final return, from Sad Ya Ra. And al-masir is the return, and the root meaning of it comes from when there's a split of something, you know, or where things return, or the final return of something. Like they use that for like the door. They say Yisir al-Bab is the door, when it, you know, when you open the door all the way to the end. So this is al-masir is everything shall return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And these verses already set the heart to follow what comes afterwards. And this is always, you know, when we recite the Quran, you have to carry meanings from one verse to the other. And the Quran, every verse is by itself knowledge for a person to learn, but also it requires for us to carry the meaning from one verse to the other. As if you're like when you're talking about something and you're establishing the foundation for something else to come afterwards, that requires for the person to not to fall into contradictions. So if a person would agree and believe that this Quran, the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which was the ulu of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala above his creation, and to believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Almighty, the Unknower subhanahu wa ta'ala, that necessitates, of course, for the person to rely upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, to follow the book of Allah, to know that the knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encompasses everything. So a person should not say or believe or do anything unless we get to know first what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us, from the wahi, from the revelation, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then you add to it these attributes of Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the forgiver of the sins, and he's the one that accepts the tawbah. So no one is to seek forgiveness except from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and to have the hearts again attached to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, and to hope for the rewards from Allah. And whoever does not repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's a bad sign. Doesn't a person know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts the repentance? So why would a person then not repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And at the same time, to have the fear of Allah, shadid al-iqab, that he subhanahu wa ta'ala is severe in punishment, because he is the creator of the heavens and the earth. And the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the promise of the truth. And with that, the tawl, beautiful combination, the one that is the bestower, the owner of all favors. So see how many different ibadah that a person would attain as a result of these few words that are mentioned. So to be grateful to Allah, and to be grateful to Allah that a person is guided to repent and to seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there's no one worthy of worship except him subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to him everyone shall return. So everyone shall return to Allah also when it comes to their belief, when it comes to their opinions, their actions, to return all matters to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us benefit. And again, this is a new surah, so we should already have memorized the previous one. And if not, also let's start memorizing the surah. And these are three simple verses, inshallah ta'ala. And when you recite them, when you repeat them, you repeat these meanings and you purify your heart while you're reciting them after understanding the meanings of them. طيب إن شاء الله we'll stop here إن شاء الله we'll continue إن شاء الله تعالى tomorrow if Allah سبحانه وتعالى will. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى صحبه وسلم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.